I'm Stephanie from Math with Miss C. The last few weeks I've gotten so many questions about pixel art, and today I'm going to walk you through one of the pixel art activities I've created and show you how you can use the template to edit in any questions for these activities. Let's get started. This is the adding decimals pixel art activity that I've created. So you'll notice in the background there's the Among Us backdrop, and as students input answers into this pixel art activity sheet, they will see colors start to fill in. Once they see a color appear in the drawing, they'll know that they are on the right track, they've answered it correctly. If you're not currently adding decimals with your students, that's totally fine, you can use this as well. So if you head over to where it says template for edit down here, I give you a template of 14 questions, and these are labeled with the answers A through N. In order to edit these, I would have you put in your own problem. So let's say you're doing some multiplication. Let's do 5 times 6, and you want to just multiply all of your 6 times 8, 6 times 9, etc., and you'll fill those problems in. And then you want to change the conditional formatting in your Google Sheet so that way it matches up to the correct answer. So I'm going to highlight all of the image. I'm clicking my fill button, clicking conditional formatting, and you'll notice under conditional formatting, all of your answer choices are shown as appearing as a certain color. So my first one, answer choice A, that I've labeled as answer A here, is D8. So my cell is D8, and that is this cell here. So if I want this cell instead to be answer A, I want to change it to 30. And that will go ahead and change this box to say that as soon as students enter the answer 30, the red will appear. So let's try that. So that works. You'll go ahead and do that for the rest of these question sets. A few things to keep in mind, if you are putting in some sort of text, like the letter A will need the quotations because that is a string of text. If you're just doing a number, you don't need those quotation marks. You could just put 30 like that. However, you would then need to change all of these cells here to a different format. So currently it's just being read as plain text. You would then need to go in and input that as a number. So that way it's being read as a digit and a number instead of as a string of text. So hopefully that helps. I know a lot of you are finding pixel art's very engaging with your students, and I have found a lot of success with these as well in my class. If you are looking for any templates, all of my pixel art activities do have a template embedded. So if you're seeing that they are not the topic you teach, but you do want to use that activity still and use that image, you can go ahead and just download those. I will also be uploading different topics under the same picture, so if you want to take a look at that, you can as well. And then if you have any topic suggestions, let me know. I can always try to customize them and then upload them to the bundle. Hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully you're able to use this with your students. Have a great day. Bye.